The dream. The dream is the heartbeat of the human spirit. It's the dream that keeps us really living in life. It keeps us pushing us. Everything really around us has begun with a dream. And the dream has taken us up into space. It's taken us to the bottom of the ocean. Dreams have given us, well, museums. It's given us technology, telephones, movies, television, everything around you, and with what you're wearing today was someone's dream. Maybe not yours, but it was someone's. Even how your mode of transportation to get here today, yeah, was someone's dream. So we all have a heart's desire. We all have something in our heart that we want to bring out into the world. So whether it is a book, writing a book, maybe it's painting, maybe it's starting a new business, maybe it's world travel, maybe it's a garden, maybe it's starting another new museum. Whatever it might be, we all have a dream, we all have a heart's desire. Sometimes we don't know what that is, sometimes we do, we just don't know how to make it happen. We get a block, and I've been there. That's actually why I wrote the book, was for my parent and I to read it, because I was once creatively blocked and did my research and decided I was going to write a book about it. But today, what I would like to do is give you some tips on how you can unlock your creative power and make that heart's desire come to fruition. So the first tip that I have for you is to ignite your inspiration. So find and discover whatever inspires you, because inspiration is what fuels us in life. And the root of the word inspire is to breathe into, like to breathe life into. And inspiration is really difficult to actually articulate what it is, but you know when you're inspired. It's almost like this surge of positive energy sort of pulls you up, pushes you along, and it's effortless, and you think about, talk about, breathe, everything related to whatever it is that you're inspired about. And I find that inspiration is also a state that is not sustained all the time. So we go in and out of inspiration. Just like we go through in and out of joy, we go in and out of anger, we go through in and out of all sorts of states. The same thing with inspiration. And the thing about inspiration too is that I don't think it's possible to be depressed if you're inspired. They're two different energies. So do whatever it takes to inspire you, and that is really the key to your really unlocking your creative power and making those creative dreams come true. And in my experience, there are a few ways to do that, generally speaking. Now, whatever is going to inspire me may not inspire you, and whatever inspires me may not inspire her. I mean, it's all very unique and individual. But at least when we know what it is, then we can do it as much as possible and often as possible. So, the first thing that I, when I give these keynotes and coach people, the first thing I tell them is to read about and watch movies about famous people who inspire you. There is, with the internet, there's a big body of information out there about famous people. And I say famous because there's that much information. We can study them. We can study their lives. And I tend to read a lot of memoirs and biographies. What I do is a little bit on the neurotic side. I pull out all the traits that make these people successful. I put them in a chart, and then I actually go and discover where I actually have the same traits. And so then I own that I have that same trait. Somewhere in my life, I will display it. And then we start to see when we do this that we are just like those people that we actually admire. We can take them off the pedestal and say, yes, I have those traits too. I did that with Einstein. I actually read a couple of biographies on Einstein. We pulled out all Einstein's traits that made him successful. And then I put it in a chart, and then I decided, well, I'm going to go find, you know, where I have those traits. I thought, right, like I have seen traits Einstein has. And I actually discovered that I do, and we all have them. You know, maybe I'm not a mathematician, but I have an understanding of math or some other areas. But what I discovered was after I did that, my hair actually started to go curly and unruly, so I decided that maybe I wasn't such a good idea to do that anymore. So study people that are famous through books and documentaries, magazine articles and whatnot. the other thing is to hang out with inspiring people. So people who inspire you. Maybe, and they're people that are accessible. So it could be your neighbor, it could be a colleague, a friend, it could be an author. If you want to write a book, it's your first book, and there's an author local that lives here. You want to meet them, well, why not get in touch with them and see if they'll have a coffee with you? So the best thing is to hang out with people who are inspiring to you, because we feed off inspiration. It's a wonderful energy. Right? Like, you know when you're around somebody who's inspired and they're just making things happen versus somebody who's really maybe, you know, sort of maybe on the other end of the scale, depressed and not able to make things happen. It's a very different energy. And then third, of course, museums are wonderful places for inspiration. So this is where it's really right into the top of the day. Museums I encourage people to visit them for an inspiration boost to come to a museum or an art gallery. You know, I mean, just to walk around and see these beautiful artifacts and paintings and whatnot, it's just so inspiring. And each one of these artists here has had a dream, has had a creative desire, and they've managed to unleash it, and they've managed to make something happen. But I think museums are wonderfully inspiring, filled with inspiration, art galleries as well. So I know that whenever I need a little inspiration, I like to come along and come down to a museum somewhere. By the way, I'm interviewing Janet Carr and Frank Long on Monday. Tuesday, actually. So ignite your inspiration. And then the second point would be become an inspiring person yourself. So learn from those who you think are inspiring and inspiring to you, and then become an inspiring person. How do we do that? Well, I think that the most inspiring people around are people who are listening to their hearts, following their hearts, and making their dreams come true. Would you agree? I mean, that's really very inspiring, making it happen. And in my experience, opening your heart with gratitude is probably one of the most inspirational things. Fear, guilt, resentment close down the heart. And when the heart closes down, we can't hear the whisper. And that whisper is our truth, our inner truth, whatever our inner truth is. But that whisper knows what we want in life. And if you ever try to lie to your heart, good luck, because it's the best lie detector test that there is. You can lie to anyone else and you can say, oh, that used to be my dream, I used to want to travel the world, but you know, I have kids now, and I have a job, and well, and I have responsibilities. Not important to me anymore, and you can say that to anyone and maybe they'll believe you, but if in here you'll know whether that's really true or not. So when we close that, when we can't hear the whisper, then self-doubt creeps in, and self-doubt kills our creativity. It's not fear, not guilt, not other anger that kills our creativity, it's actually self-doubt. So self-doubt kills our creativity, we can't hear the whisper, then we doubt ourselves more because we can't make things happen, we can't make our dream come true and get depressed. So it becomes a cycle. So the best thing we can do is to live with gratitude. And when we are finding challenges in life, when we're writing a book and it's not going the way we want it, or we can't find that publisher, we can't find a literary agent, or you know, when we are getting a museum off the ground and all the challenges that come with that. For all those challenges, just stop and say, how is this serving me? How is this getting me where I want to go? How is this making my dream come true? And that shift is just enough for us to often to just sort of push past that obstacle. So become an inspiring person. You're going to inspire others around you. I'm sure there'll be other people who will be inspired to start museums when I hear you talk. People who have dreams and you'll inspire them and they'll inspire someone else. And I think this is actually one way that we can sort of lift up the human spirit of humanity across the board. And then third would be live with courage. Creativity requires courage. It requires to be all the artists here were courageous in being able to it's like making yourself naked in the world, right? They created their art and they had enough courage to share that with the world, because a lot of us will hold back. I know when I've got other projects, it's like, it's not good enough, I don't want to show it till it's perfect, whatnot. But really, it takes a lot of courage to share your art with the world. And the thing about creation is that creation actually begins with destruction. So creation is first and foremost an act of destruction. So if you think of a house, before you build up the house, you actually have to dig a foundation. And it's like that with creativity. So when you start with, when we're creating anything, we actually have to break down something first. If it's an idea or if it's a belief, whatever it might be, creation actually starts with destruction. And that actually also takes courage as well. So taking risks. And one of the best things that we can do is push out our comfort zone, because our comfort zone is here, but our dreams are out there. You know, whatever's in our heart to create, that book, that movie, or starting a museum and making it successful, whatever it is, that dream is outside our comfort zone. And the more we push our comfort zone, the more risks we take. The more risks we take, the more we push out our comfort zone. And so it's up there. So, you know, live with courage and take risks. So if you follow then these three tips, then I'm sure that you can find something in there to unlock your creativity and make your dreams come true. And hopefully maybe we'll see some, you know, see a museum rolling across Canada, Love Brighton Centre. But anyway, all the best to you, and I hope there's something in there that's a takeaway.